Good morning, class 7 student. Today I am going to give you a small summary of the lesson 2 from English, that is Helen Keller. Actually the story of Helen Keller talks about the willpower and firm determination that can take one on a long way ahead in life. And Helen Keller at that time, the story actually is about a blind little girl, Helen Keller, who fought all the odds of life and she won herself happiness and pride. Actually, Helen Keller had her parents, her father's name Captain Arthur Keller and kid Adam Keller live in Tuscumbia. Helen Keller's father was Captain Arthur Keller, who was in the army earlier, and later he earned a living as both a cotton plantation owner and the editor of a weekly local newspaper. Her mother was Kate Adams Keller. They lived in Tuscumbia, a small town in Northwest Alabama. Alabama, that is present in USA, United States of America. Actually, at the age of 19 months, Helen Keller fell ill. She was recovered from the ill, but it was unfortunate when her fever subsided. Okay, she stopped responding to sound, sight, and simple actions. That means she could not see. She lost her eyesight, and also she became deaf, and she was unable to listen or hear to it. And when she was not responding to her father's claps or not responding, she was not blinking with the sunlight when she directly see towards the sunlight, and it became a great challenge for Keller. And finally she start becoming rude to the people. Her behavior became unreasonable and it upset the parents, and it upset her parents. She became an ill-tempered, miserable, and lonely child. Okay, so here what happened? At her childhood, Helen became a very difficult child. She threw tantrums and screamed at everybody. Helen became an ill-tempered, miserable, and lonely child. She was rude to people. Her impolite table manners and her social behavior needed attention. So to guide her, Ellen Sullivan, a lady, was hired to guide Helen Keller. And the lady, she changed Helen's life. Helen developed great confidence and she even visited President Cleveland at the White House. Annie Sullivan taught her to speak with the letters, with the alphabets. Annie Sullivan used to write some alphabets on her skin, on Helen Keller's skins, and Helen Keller identified the alphabets, and finally she could identify the alphabets and forming the words. And in this way she started learning to spell doll, milk, mother, teacher, even her name Helen Keller. And her learning didn't stop there. She started to progressed in her learning. Helen Keller's first teacher was Annie Sullivan. Helen's communication with the world was largely through Annie. Now, as Helen was rude, Annie stopped talking with her, as it was the only means of communication was Annie Sullivan with Helen Keller. So it was like a punishment for Helen Keller. At the age of 10, she moved to the Perkins Institution. She learned Latin, German, and even arithmetic. She attended the Wright Humason School for the Deaf. That means that people who do not listen, who can't listen. In 1896, she moved on to the Cambridge School for young ladies in Massachusetts. In 1900, Helen entered Radcliffe College. And after 4 years, that is in 1904, she graduated. And it was an immense effort of Helen that she have contributed in her life. She was able to succeed. She was able to overcome her all the odds, her all the problems. Okay, and now Helen felt that she must educate people on the ways or to help the blind. Her main goal in life was to spread awareness regarding the poor, neglected state of the blind, their innate abilities and their aspirations. She had to raise funds not only to sustain a living. That means she need to live, she have to raise funds, she have to earn something for herself, but also to start project to remove darkness from the lives of other blind. This she thought she could do best by giving lectures and writings. She strongly felt that she must give the other what she had gained from Annie. That is Annie, her teacher, the first teacher whom Helen Keller was taught by her. So Adams Helen Keller had written this one, this story, and it has given to us to learn to understand a person whenever he or she is disabled, unable to cope with the environment, unable to cope with the situation, but because of their innate abilities, because of their effort put upon their life, they are successful now. So I hope so you will understand. If you don't understand, you do ask me, and after this lesson next day I will provide you with the answers and also following homework. So you need to submit the homework. If you submit the homework, then I will understand that you are interested in the classes which are being done by me in online. Thank you.